exponent of megatonics and this calibration of thermocouple and RTD. So in this we have to calibrate the thermocouple and RTD. There are different types of thermocouples, J type, K type, and RTD is the resistance temperature detector. So this is the table for J type thermocouple. In this we have to take 5 readings, that is temperature set on PID controller 30, 40, 50, 60, and 70°C. In second column is room temperature in millivolts, that is room temperature generally 28°C. So in millivolts it is converted to 1.176 millivolts. Then there will be a millivolts observed on indicator, then thermocouple millivolts, that is column B plus C, that is room temperature, and millivolts observed on indicator, that will be added to give the millivolts, that is the output of the thermocouple. Then there is a chart, standard charts. Okay. We have to compare between these two readings, and the difference is the error. If the error is permissible, then it is said that the thermocouple is calibrated or there is something misfunctioning in the thermocouple. Now we will go to the setup. So this is our setup of calibration of thermocouple and RTD. So you can see the controller. Here we can set the temperatures. Now it is set at 40°C. So it can be increased to 50°. As per desired, it can be increased or decreased. Now I have set it at 50°C. So there is the arrangement of fan and heater. Here you can see the thermocouple and RTD. This can be put in the coil. There are holes arranged to put the thermocouple and RTD. So around this there is a coil, heater coil. So the temperature is getting controlled with the help of coil and fan arrangement. So it is automatic controller. When the temperature rises beyond set point, the fan starts and it gets cools. And when the temperature is below set point, the heater is getting on. You can see the indicator. Now heater is on and temperature rises. The second panel is the display panel. Here you can see the output of thermocouple. This is in millivolts, 7.75 millivolts. It is increasing. And the second output is in terms of ohms. This is the output of RTD. The output of RTD is in terms of ohms. Also, you can see the arrangements. This is RTD with 3 wires, positive, negative, and ground. And thermocouple with 2 wires, positive and negative. Now the voltage rises and it gets stable after some time. You have to give the time period for this to stable the output. Then you can take the readings. So this is the reading for 50°C. Now temperature has dropped because there is a loss of heat to surrounding. Now the reading is approximately 189.8°C, and the second reading is 12.97 millivolts. This is for thermocouple. In this way we can take the readings for 60°, 70°. We will take the 5 readings and put it in the table and do the calculations. Now you can see the in the table I have put the values for 5 readings. This millivolt observed on indicator is 1.89 for 30 degree centigrade, 2.51 for 40, 3.22 millivolt for 50 degree, 4 millivolt for 60 degree and 4.31 for 70 degree centigrade. Then B and C column is added to get the D column final readings. These are the readings and it is compared with the chart. These are the standard chart which are referred for all India, and the values are compared and the difference is written in the error column, that is F column. You can see the readings, the difference is constant 1.373, 1.313, 1.334, 1.300. So the reading variation is one near about 1.3 to 1.5 in the range. So it is nearly constant. The same readings you can take for K-type thermocouple, no change, the observation table is same and the procedure is also same. And for RTD, you can see the table, we have to take the same readings with the resistance values and we have to find out the temperature coefficient of resistance. The formula is given here, alpha is equal to R1 minus R0 divided by R0 into delta T. And we have to plot a graph of this. This is a graph for thermocouple and RTD. The sample graph is given here. Take a proper scale and on x-axis there is temperature and on y-axis there is a millivolts. Finally, we will draw the conclusion. It is concluded that variation of temperature of J-type thermocouple and K-type thermocouple with the temperature is linear. The graph is linear, little bit straight line, linear curve nature is there, and variation of K-type thermocouple is more than J-type thermocouple. And if the difference in the error is very large, then it is said that the thermocouple or RTD is not working as per standard, so we have to recalibrate the RTDs. And if the variation is near about constant, then RTD or thermocouple is said to be working fine and okay. Thank you.